Hi, this is Sean, and in this video we're going to make an interactive door. In fact, we're going to make an interactive drawbridge. So, let's get started. In the last video, we made a very basic elevator, that when you bumped into it, the elevator would go up, it would repeat itself. But in this one, we're going to do something a little bit more complicated. What if you wanted the drawbridge to be triggered when you bumped into a trigger, or even, let's say, there was a button here that we wanted to use and activate. So let's try that with a trigger this time. So we're going to add an actor, we're going to add a trigger, and we're going to make this, for prototyping purposes, we're going to make the trigger visible. So I've unchecked the hidden icon here. We're going to go into Kismet. We're going to say new event using trigger used. Now, in order to make this used trigger a little bit more friendly, I like to uncheck aim to interact. Potentially even add just a little more distance. What do we need to do in order to make this animate? First of all, we need to make sure this isn't a static mesh. So I'm going to right-click and convert this to a mover. So now it's been converted. It's an interp actor. I do want to also set the collision to block all. And now I'm going to set up a matinee and add a few keyframes of animation so that it will rotate and come down when I trigger it. So let's say we've got that selected. I'm going to right click, say new matinee. I'm going to say when this is used, play the matinee. And I double click on matinee, we open up the matinee sequence. So I need to right click here, create an empty group, call this draw, and that links the object and creates a variable inside of Kismet. So you can see drawbridge, and it's attached to the interp actor. Now we need to say what exactly we're going to do with that drawbridge. What we're going to do is we're going to move and rotate it. So if I right click here, I need to find movement track. So add new movement track. So here we are. It comes with a keyframe. I'm going to move the current time indicator to 1 second. Hit enter as I did before to create a keyframe. I'm going to rotate this. If I needed to cycle through controls here, I could use the space bar. I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees. And that should get up the keyframe all set. I also need to set the out point. So I'm going to drag the red triangle to 2 seconds. So anytime I activate this drawbridge, it'll take 1 second to come down and wait 1 second. But it won't necessarily repeat this time. The question is, do I want it to go back up when it's completed? If I did, what would I need to do? I could take this completion output and set this to reverse. What else? With all triggers, if I want them to be used multiple times, I need to set the max trigger count to infinite. So this would be need to be set to 0. One additional problem is, once this goes up, if I want my character to be able to get back across this area, I would need to be able to set some sort of interactivity here, some sort of controls. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create an additional trigger right here. Got another trigger. We'll do the same steps that we did before. We'll go in, unhide it, right click, add new event using trigger for used. We'll do the same steps as well here. What did we do? We unchecked aim to interact. Makes it a little easier to interact with. Increase the aim, the interact distance. So same thing, when it's used, we can play. That should do it. Let's give this a try. So we'll play from here. hit the E key to interact. The drawbridge comes down. I'm going to go across the bridge. The bridge came back up. I'm going to hit the E key on this. And there we are. So great. That should just about do it. We could set up these interactive triggers to do multiple items as well. We could turn on lights, turn off lights, turn on a sequence of lights. There's quite a few options, but this is a good start for showing interactivity and for setting keyframes. So that's going to be all for now. Thanks so much for watching.